Hello, this is the RPG Crawler, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Neverwinter Nights original campaign. We are in the Host Tower of Luskan, and we're heading on up. We're going to do the 8th floor and then the pinnacle, and we should be done with this chapter. Alright, so what's up here on the 8th floor? This is a big area. A lot of open space. It's like an open war ground over there. Let's go ahead and start an ice storm. Just kill everything. Ah! Fucking Vrock. Okay, there's a summon succubus. Yeah, I don't even know why I expected that to land. Most demons are resistant to, or is it devils that are resistant / immune to fire? I forget. Here's a loot bag. Alright, Karach will see the flesh torn from your bones. I don't think so. Okay, you guys want to kill this for me? Like, any time now? That's way more black tentacles than I cast. Out of our way. Go ahead and check over here. Got another portal stone. Another ring of invisibility. Because they just love dropping rings of invisibility, I guess. Go on, kill it. There we go. So all of this for so little return. So what is up here? Some potions. So it was a big fight for, like, maybe a couple items. That was, like, not even worth it. Couple gold. Got some crates over here. And then finally, this chest here, which I'm going to bash in. All of that for a couple potions. Oh, Shadow Conjuration, which I don't think I have. I'm not going to use it, but at least I've got it now. And then the pinnacle is next. Let's head up the stairs. All the way to the pinnacle. So, what do we got in here? Quickly, let's take a look. We've got, like, two rooms. Arklum? Ah, I see the fly in the ointment has finally arrived. You were expecting me? Are you surprised? This tower is a living thing in its own manner. To anyone as accustomed to his rhythms as myself, you are the veritable bull in a china shop. I have been in contact with my dear Nephthys, and she has told me much about you. Sadly, she has not been able to reach our old sanctum as you have, or I would already be free. You are Arklum Greith, then, the former Archmage Arcane? So my own reputation precedes me. Yes, you have the right of it, little mortal. I fled the tower when Margrim showed his true intention, but not quickly enough. Margrim is the power you cannot even imagine. His mistress favors him, and even the tower granted me by this... even the power granted me by this form could not resist capture in the end. Interesting. Transformed yourself into a lich, have you? I have, at Nephthys' advice. In fact, it has proven remarkably beneficial, both for myself and the Brotherhood. Margrim was a surprise. He is my enemy, and that means our interests coincide, yes? Free me from this magical prison, mortal. You assist me, and I shall assist you. Sure. Can you reward me for letting you go? A reward? Certainly, my dear human. Friend, I can reward you. You see that door that leads to my sanctum? Have you tried to open it? It is locked tightly with spells that I'm pretty sure that are beyond even your ability to dispel. I happen to know that Mogrim lies beyond it. He is the one you came here for, no? I created the spells that hold the door. I can open it for you, but only if I am freed. It's either that, or you're certainly free to return once you came, in failure. Sure, how do I get you out of here, then? You see the four braziers that find... Braziers, not braziers. They sustain the magic that Mogrim keeps me held within. In much the same manner that Nephethys was held. They are protected by their own magic. Too much for me to overcome on my own. If you were to damage them, however, now is to add my power to yours, they could be freed and destroyed, and I could be freed. Attack them however you wish, and I will turn my own effort towards aiding you. Okay. Sure, you can't. You can trust, however, that I would rather be away from here than deal with you myself. Have you another chance? All right, let's do this. Okay, there's four braziers. Go ahead and bash it. Go ahead and acid arrow. And I will acid arrow this one. And I will acid arrow this one. And it looks like they're summoning creatures. Wait a minute. Okay, yeah, this is unfortunate. My familiar is dead. Yeah, you wanna take it as fire elemental? Boom! Here. Oh no, there goes my my minion. Yeah, I have to get out of here now. That was a little bit too brutal for me. Let me get everything done here. Alright, on my way back. Let's go ahead and kill this shit now. Come on, kill the bone golem, please. Thank you. Damn. They beat the hell out of my familiar. Well, I guess it is a greater fire elemental. Come on. Got one near death. I should have really killed... I should have taken those braziers out one at a time. Come on, you want to kill this? Please? Sigh. And there we go. Got this last guy to deal with. Again with the strength drain. God damn, kill that thing, please. That's the most annoying one out of everything. I guess I'm gonna rest after this. Or not. Let's try and keep this rolling. Get an acid arrow on there. Please don't aggro this guy. Okay. There we go. Ah! A death slod. Yeah, you want to assist me, Arklum? You're just gonna watch me fight. Oh my god. He's not gone, he's just invisible. My god, people. The cat sees it. Well, if the cat wants to beat it up while it's invisible, I guess that works. There we go. Oh, now she's attacking it while it's invisible. Come on. This is ridiculous. Stop going invisible. There we go. Damn. Yeah, I need a rest after that. Holy shit. Alright, let's talk to Arklum. It is done. I am free at last. Would that I could visit vengeance upon Margrim for this indignity myself. But you? You intend to be the fly in Margrim's ointment, do you not? That will do. I will tell you what I know of his desires, little mortal. Have you not wondered at the nature of Margrim's mistress? How is it that she gives him such power? The plague was loosed to strengthen her, you see. Each death in Neverwinter fed her with new life force. And I know she seeks even more power yet. Margrim is desperate to find what he calls the words of power. They are ancient artifacts, I believe, 4 in total, though I have never heard of them before Margrim himself made mention. He holds only one, but his mistress wishes them all. What these words of power would do for Margrim and his mistress, one can only guess. I'm sure you can. It would amuse me to see you halt their efforts, if that is your goal. I give you thanks for my freedom, mortal. I shall open the door to my sanctum. You may deal with Margrim at your leisure. Do not be here, however, when I return. Sure, not a problem. I go ahead and open this up and head on up. And up to the pinnacle. Up to the very top. It's kind of rainy. Holy shit, there's a lot of stuff over there. Go ahead and open this up. A note. What does that note say? I've got another Stone of Recall. By the nature of this note, it is clear that the body upon which it was found was that of a spy in Aaron Genn's employ. His mission had been to protect Lady Arabeth from any hidden dangers that might have been befallen her. Like her turning rogue. What's down here? Oh, wait. That's Arabeth. Yeah, you gonna let me in?
Do you renounce your false god of justice, Arabeth de Tavaran? Do you renounce your god?
Yo, you just gonna stand there and watch? I mean, as amusing as it is.
I do.
Will you lead our glorious army in the name of your new mistress?
I will lead them.
Then be the terrifying blackguard of our mistress Morad that you are meant to.
I shall. Neverwinter will fall before our minds.
That it is of great importance that the other words of power be located. You must beware Hatred, however, as she will.
Yeah. You just noticed me. Intruders. Come on, let me in. Let's go ahead and get a tentacles in there. And a fireball. And a nice ice storm. That was almost too easy.
Shall decorate
Lizard Volt Mage. There we go. And there's one person over here. Let's go ahead and check these crates out. What cloak is this? Protection versus chaos. Might have been useful at one point. Oh man, I am full up. Well, what are these remains? I guess I gotta go down here. Into Mogrim's lair. It's just got a stone golem. Nymph's cloak plus 3 and Mogrim's journal. And we'll read the journal as soon as that golem's dead. Oh wait, there's more. Okay. Where's Mogrim's journal? This small book is filled sparsely with notes in Mogrim's now familiar scrawl. Several entries are of particular interest. The tower is ours. The overambitious fool Arklam trusted me far too much. I would gladly have ended his undead existence had this demon witch not sent him away so quickly. Well, he'll not have use of her advice any longer. I've seen to that. Morag is displeased with me, however. So far, the wizards I have sent forth from the tower have found only one of the words of power. She needs them all. We shall have the one in Neverwinter soon, and once the last three are located, all shall be as Morag wished. I am confident of success. The plague ravages Neverwinter, just as Morag foretold. With each death by the wailing, she grows stronger. Already she is able to appear in corporeal form, and with the coming war she shall become even stronger still. I have received word that the old fool Nasher has been successful in stopping the plague, having acquired some help from adventurers. No matter, the deed is already done. Neverwinter is weakened, and what strength it has is lost. Morag has gained. Morag says that Nasher's execution of the fool Fenthic will only serve us. Soon his greatest champion shall be ours instead. The High Captains decimate each other daily, just as I suspected. I care not whether any of the fools actually succeed. Better is that they all die, for none of them will lead the army as I have promised them. Morag's nightly visits to Arabeth have had the desired effect. The former paladin has come and lain herself willingly at our feet. She shall lead the great host herself as Morag's champion. The words will be ours, and Morag shall triumph. Glorious shall be the day. All right. Brutal. So I guess I gotta go turn this shit in. Because it's clear that ain't nothing coming up here for us. Let's head back to Aaron Gend. Okay, I have discovered all I can about the cult in the host tower.
Well done, my friend. I knew Lord Nash's faith in you was well justified. Come then, tell me.
Tell Aaron about Mogrim and Arabeth's betrayal.
This enemy is far more elusive than I suspected, even. For the name of this Mogrim is unfamiliar to me. As is this creature you describe as his mistress.
Okay.
The Lady Arabeth has fallen to become a blackguard. And even leads their gathering army is far worse than anything I had feared.
You know, she really didn't do that much. It would have been much worse if I had decided to lead them.
But what of this Mogrim's purpose, my friend? Were you able to discover anything of the reasoning behind all this madness?
Tell Aaron about the words of power.
This is perhaps the first good news I have heard so far. It shows us that we are ignorant of much and must catch up quickly if we are to survive. But at least you have brought us hope.
Indeed.
Come then. Let us return to Lord Nasher quickly and relate what you have discovered. Then perhaps we will see what must be done next.
All right. And that, I believe, finishes Chapter 2, and we're into Chapter 3. Beruna's Well. Is there a cutscene? Yep.
Within the host tower of the Arcane, the enemy was finally revealed. Morgrim Korothir, madman, prophet, the one responsible for the wailing death. And with this revelation, a second betrayal.
Arabeth's gonna...
Driven mad by
you know,
mother's execution,
she's just a blackbird.
Joining Morgrim's
corpse. I'm gonna...
Together, they
go out on a limb and say that by the time I fight her, I'll be able to one-shot her almost.
Neverwinter. But an even greater evil threatened the city.
The words of power.
Remnants of ancient magic long forgotten.
Not to be mistaken with actual words of power spells.
Followers to bring devastation to the north. Neverwinter's champions were sent to the
north. I have no idea who that is.
Uthgard tribes to unearth these lost artifacts. For if Morgrim were to find the words of power.
And I guess
first,
I got to fight barbarians.
The city of the north would surely fall.
And here we are. I have no idea how much my inventory is packed. I've got to go through and disrupt everything. Okay, we've got all of our followers
this
here.
This has become something of a habit, has it not? Once more, Neverwinter is threatened, and once more you are called upon to save us all.
Indeed.
Yet this time you will be reporting directly to me. With Arabeth's defection, Lord Nashor has elevated me from the role of spymaster to that of his right hand.
Sounds like a plan.
To be honest, I much prefer to stay in the shadows. Yet Neverwinter has need of me, so I will serve without complaint.
There are worse ways to make a living. Neverwinter pays her servants well.
Neverwinter has need of all her allies now, whether they serve for honor, duty, or gold.
I have
examined the reconnaissance reports of my operatives in the field, and the situation is...
So I gotta disrupt an army, I bet.
The Luskan armies are marching against Neverwinter with Erebeth at their head, ravaging the land as they pass and leaving only destruction in their wake. Perhaps even more troubling are the reports of orcs and some of the Uthgard tribes joining Erebeth.
Yeah, they were supposed to follow their ambassadors, I guess. Is there no one who comes to the defense of Neverwinter?
The Lord's Alliance has come to our aid. Without them, our plague-weakened city would already have come under siege.
But that's probably not enough.
Several of the Uthgard stand with us. The Red Tiger and Black Lion tribes have made camp with us here at Biaruna's Well, an Uthgard holy site. But Erebeth and the Luskan army are best left to the generals in the field. You have a much more important mission.
Have your spies learned anything of Morgrim?
The few reports I have heard of Morgrim indicate he is not with the Luskan army. It seems he is content to leave the battles to Erebeth. I believe Erebeth and the Luskan invaders are but a decoy, a distraction to draw our troops and resources away from the true threat.
All right, a decoy?
It has not been easy to gather information on Mogrim's cult.
So, what am I doing out here in the Uthgard area if we're being drawn away from Neverwinter?
Though we do not yet know what these words are, or why Morgrim desires them, we know there are at least three of these artifacts. We must not let them fall into the hands of the cult. You must find these
ancient words. So I've got to find these ancient words before Morgrim.
If you do not, then
I can do that.
Victory by the Lord's Alliance will prove meaningless.
All right, any idea where I should be looking for them?
There are reports of Morgrim's followers searching throughout the land. The hills and mountains to the north. The forests to the west. Even the sprawling farmlands to the south. I wish I had more guidance for you. Perhaps you can learn more from Lillian Cambridge, an expert on ancient artifacts, who claims to have some...
So we've got an expert this time.
Lillian has promised to offer whatever help she can to any of my agents in this matter. You could probably find her in the tavern in the southeast corner of the camp. I know this may seem an impossible task, but
I can do
no
it.
Other person I would rather have undertaking this mission.
And what should I do once I find these words
if
of power?
If you find one of the words, bring it back to me here. My underground network will transport it to the safety...
That seems particularly unwise. All right, anything else?
I regret there is nothing more I can tell you. Even the little information I have already given came at great cost. Many of my best men and women gave their lives for it.
All right, I'll be going now.
I wish you luck in your mission. The very survivor.
Let's go ahead and pick up our henchmen. It's good to see you, Charwin.
Somehow I knew you couldn't be far. As soon as Aaron Gend mentioned why we were brought here, I began wondering when you would pop up.
It's good to see you again, Charwin. Did I say it was good to see you? I only said I knew you'd come. Haha, I only jest, RPG. Of course it is good that you're here. I wasn't going to come to Biron as well, originally. I figured I had done enough by your side, but the story isn't finished just yet, is it? And you know what a sucker I am for a good tale. So what do you say then, RPG? Shall we join together again? I want to see this unfold firsthand. Sure. I am at your disposal once again, RPG. All right. And there is, I'm presuming, like an adjacent room that just leads out. And this also just leads out. Birona's Well. How big is this place? Please don't be that big. Okay, it's not that big. So I've got to find... Let's see, there's the drinking house, there's a mercenary enclave, there's Aaron Gen's lodge, which I think I just stepped out of. Many-starred cloak enclave, which is good. And we'll step in here. Into the drinking house. So there's Lillian Cambridge. About time you showed up. There we go. I'm not here to fill your drink. I'm RPG Crawler. I work for Aaron Gend. Ah, yes, the hero of Neverwinter. I'd drink a toast to your legendary deeds if my glass wasn't empty. Goddamn lush. That's all right. My name is Lillian Cambridge, archaeologist. I'm the North's leading expert in antiquities and ancient artifacts. No doubt Aaron Gend has told you that I've come to offer my rather unique knowledge to aid the cause of the Lord's Alliance. Like to ask some questions? That's why I'm here, to answer your questions about the words of power and the creator race that constructed them. And to sample the local wines, of course. Where can I find the words of power? If it were as simple as drawing you a map, RPG, I'd have told Aaron Gend everything I know. You have to remember that the words are thousands and thousands of years old. The creator race that fashioned the words predated even the first elven kingdoms. Everything I know about them is theory and conjecture upon a foundation of myth and legend. Surely you must know something. I can tell you that there were several words of power created, but they have been scattered throughout the North and lost for countless millennia. All that remain are rumors of where they may have disappeared. Some believe the words were taken by the dragons who dwell in the mountains to the west. Others claim clues to their location may be found in the long deserted ruins far to the south of Fort Ilkerd, or hidden in the forests to the north. The truth is, they could be anywhere, though I believe I have learned the location of one of the words after many years of research and study. Before I tell you the location of the word of power, I need you to perform a task. God damn it! This is the world we're talking about! Something very precious was stolen from me recently, a snow globe I had acquired on behalf of a very wealthy benefactor. If you want me to tell you what I know about the location of the word of power, you'll have to recover that snow globe for me. I don't want this to get nasty. Spare me your threats, RPG. Aaron Gend himself has invited me here. What do you think you will do if you choose to harm me? Bring me my snow globe and I will gladly tell you what I know about the location of the word of power. However, until I get the snow globe, the secret remains with me. Where can I find this snow globe? I was en route to deliver the snow globe to my buyer when it was stolen from me by an unscrupulous, albeit rather charming wizard named Nax. From what he told me, Nax was in these parts doing some research on his own. It seems he found a magical entrance to the deserted laboratory of a long-dead wizard somewhere in the cold wood to the north. I'll bet Nax is exploring that laboratory right now and with my snow globe at his side. But if you want me to go after him, you'll need this teleportation scroll. Nax told me it was the only way to pass through the magical portal leading to the dungeon. How did you manage to get this teleportation scroll, and why did Nax tell you this? I'm a capable and attractive woman, and I'm not above using my charms to further my archaeological investigations. Nax offered to buy me a few drinks. We got to researching about, talking about our respective researches, and one thing led to another. Afterwards, when Nax fell asleep, I borrowed the scroll and slipped off to have copies made before returning the scroll to his pack. I plan to do a little investigating of this dungeon on my own later on. But while I was out making copies, Nax took my snow globe. I didn't notice until he was long gone. I guess it's my own fault for leaving him asleep in my room. I don't carry a grudge against Nax for what he did. I just want the snow globe back. Deliver it to me, and I'll tell you the location of one of the words of power. Okay, sounds like it's important. What else will you give me if I bring it back for you? What's this? You haven't even begun the task, and already the sordid topic of compensation has come up? Bring me the snow globe, and we'll talk. There's no point fixing a price when you don't even have the item on you. All right. Not a problem. What else is there to talk about in here? We've got Averick.
I greet you.
Shove off, buddy. These open sores on my face make it tough enough to attract the ladies without your ugly mug cramping around. I got a serious attitude problem. So what are you going to do about it? You try anything and every Lord's Alliance soldier in this camp will be all over you. So take your prissy complaints about my attitude, stick them where the sun don't shine, and leave me alone. Okay. Talk to Lodar.
Well met.
Look, don't bother me right now. I got a lot on my mind. What with this trial and all? What trial? One of them Uthgard killed Griff. Stabbed him right in the gut. I saw the whole thing, so now I got to testify to Nurik over that the temple is setting the whole thing up. I don't want to be rude, but this trial's got me kind of worked up. I don't feel much like talking to you right now. Go talk to Nurik if you want to know more. Oh my. Got a barkeep, got a shady character, got somebody over there, commoners. Let's take a look at the hay. I guess we'll talk to Nurik. This is just hay, obviously for the horses. All right, then. So we get to talk to Nurik again. I'm guessing he'll be at the temple. Wherever that is. Temple of Tyr. All right, there's Nurik. Oh, greetings, RPG. It's me, Nurik. Remember, I was serving in Tyr's church in Port Last until Aaron Gend asked me to come and oversee this temple here at Barona's Well. Good to see you again. I'm surprised you remember me, RPG. What with everything on your mind, the Luskan call, Tarabeth's betrayal? Why, that's enough to make someone forget their own name. Why am I, like, twitching like that? To be honest, I almost didn't recognize you, the great hero of Neverwinter. I'm struggling with a problem that's had me a little out of sorts lately. Maybe I can help you with this problem. I don't know. This is a very delicate matter. Recently, an Uthgard tribesman named Rolgan killed one of the Lord's Alliance soldiers. He claims it was self-defense, and I have given him sanctuary here to save him from the vengeance of the soldier's friends. But Rolgan cannot stay in the temple forever. I'm trying to arrange a fair trial for the young man, but his Uthgard friends are unfamiliar with our justice system, and none of the Lord's Alliance mercenaries wants to defend him during the trial. I could represent him for a price. Those who serve the cause of justice will be well rewarded, if not by Tyr himself, then at least by the Just God's priests. If you present a proper defense, I will see you compensated accordingly. After careful consideration, I have selected the jury. There will be two who represent the interests of the Uthgar, two who represent the mercenaries, and my own acolyte, Edigar. I felt this was the only way to be fair. If you agree to undertake this case, I can give you the details. I'll do it. Sure. Take this notebook. It contains information on the jurors and witnesses, as well as the details of the case and the trial itself. As an officer of Tyr, you must keep the notebook to record the progress of the case. I can summarize the notebook for you. First, the jurors. A mercenary named Averick, whom I talked to, a ranger named Dalsia, a soldier named Jevon, an Uthgard wise woman called Paula, and of course my own acolyte, Edigar. Feel free to speak to any of the jurors before the trial. It is common practice to do so in these matters. Okay. The ranger and Paula can be found in the Uthgard camp. The others are here in the buildings housing the Lord's Alliance members. And about the witnesses? The prosecutor has advised me that he will be calling two mercenaries who were witness the event, Zed and Lodar. He will also question Vanda, the wife of the accused. I suggest you speak to these people before the trial to gather what evidence you can. And of course there's the Uthgard himself, Rolgan. He doesn't have to testify, but if you call upon him to defend his actions, then the prosecutor will also be able to ask to question him. He is here in the back of the temple here, if you wish to speak with him. All right, I'll begin the investigations right away. Rolgan is counting on you to bring forth the truth at his trial. Once you have all the evidence, come speak to me and we can begin the proceedings. All right, so I am called to be a lawyer this time. Got all kinds of people in here.
Hello to you.
This is just the Stone of Recall guy. I'm presuming there's the recall portal, yeah. And there's Erdogar.
Sorry.
And there's Bard from the other side. And there's Rolgan, the accused. Alright, now I'll go ahead and question all of them a little later on, actually. I'll see what else is in Barenna's Well or whatever. We've got the Many-Starred Cloak Enclave. Let's see what they have for me now. There we go.
Welcome to this rather temporary branch of the Guild of the Many-Starred Cloak. Rest assured that even here, your membership cloak will grant you all the privileges you've come to expect from our guild. Is there some particular item of strange and wondrous magical properties that you seek? Or perhaps you've come to make use of the little laboratory I've set up in the back?
Like to purchase some magic supplies? And I'm probably going to sell a bunch of shit. Not seeing anything in particular that I need to worry about here. Greater Belt of the Guiding Light. That's actually kind of neat. Cloak of Fortification, don't need those. Don't really need any of this. Scrolls and potions, yeah, I'm going to definitely have to go ahead and check out all of these scrolls between between episodes, probably. Amulet of Natural Armor plus 3. I'll have to go ahead and pick that up. Yeah, this is all stuff that I need. Not really that bad. Let's head up here. And this is where I can make shit. The wizard's chest to go ahead and craft stuff. And the wizard's table with a random assortment of ingredients. She hasn't got a quest for me, though, has she?
Is there some particular...
Okay, why is there a branch of the Maystard Guild out here? Do not let the stereotype of the solitary wizard and tower color your perception, etc., etc. Iron Gand requested our presence. Alright. So, no major quest from her. Not seeing anything else in terms of questability. Some various Uthgart tribesmen. And there's the trading post, which I also suspect is not going to have anything useful. Tell you what, I'm going to wrap it up here. We're going to have a little bit of a short episode this time compared to the last two, but that's mostly because it was a chapter transition. And we will see about continuing on throughout this area in the next episode. For now, this has been the RPG Crawler with Neverwinter Nights original campaign. If you like what you've seen, remember to leave a like, comment if you've got feedback, and subscribe for more RPG content. Until next time, take care and goodbye.